So this new Star Wars trailer came out, Mark.
Oh, good evening.
Oh, good evening. My name's Ozum.
And I'm Mark Palmer.
You're watching Two Trump Plusies discuss the new Star Wars trailer.
We don't actually normally introduce them, do we?
Kinda. We have. We might. Doesn't really matter. Can either, you know. My notes is, I'm on the wrong page in my notes here.
So Star Wars!
Ray, that we have training sequences. She's being trained finally.
But by who?
I don't know.
Herself?
Ghost Luke.
Ghost Luke, yeah, that's Luke. The obvious solution.
Gook.
Gook. We're getting trained by Gook.
Well, I could think, well, I was watching those training sequences.
Is Gook's training?
Well, yeah. And also, this should have been The Last Jedi.
Yeah, right? Oh, they could have, you know what they could have done to make this movie feel less rushed? Put this in the last movie.
I feel like if JJ just had done the middle one, if they'd given him 3 years in between movies and he'd just done them all, there would have been a less, like, cohesive theme and feeling throughout the trilogy.
There wouldn't have been this ridiculous thing where it's like, oh, here's Kylo Ren's mask. Oh,
let's shatter the mask.
Oh, let's repair the mask.
Luke's dead now.
And put
bring
it back
him back.
On. You know, like it's
doesn't feel cohesive and fluent. It feels
It feels like obviously JJ Abrams wanted him to have that mask on.
Mm.
It's nothing to do with his character.
It's cool.
He's like, what? So he came to this big epiphany. He wants to let the past die, and then all of a sudden he just goes, no, wait a second. Actually, except for Darth Vader.
Actually, we need to relive the past again and again. C-3PO, mate. He's got cancer. He's dying.
Thank
What'd he say?
Fuck.
Taking one last look, sir. At my friends.
Because I have cancer.
Was that supposed to make me feel something?
I mean, I am a lifelong... No, I'm not a lifelong Star Wars friend. I got a fan. I got into Star Wars when I was 9. I've been into Star Wars for a long time, but I never gave a fuck about 3PO. I mean, I didn't hate him when I was a kid watching the original trilogy. But I didn't... Like, I got nothing out of him.
Yeah, no. What the fuck would ya?
I mean, it'd be very hard for a filmmaker to make me feel sentimental about him. It's possible if I was... But it'd be very hard. You'd need to be like a great filmmaker to hit all those beats and the music cues and the editing
and
that.
His
acting.
Character could not make what me he's... ever care about him.
Yeah. C-3PO.
I'm sorry. He's just not an interesting character.
Mm.
Okay, so in this trailer, I was like, I don't know, I was excited about this movie, but there's something about this trailer that I didn't like.
Feels very stock and boring.
Yeah, it feels, to be honest right now, it feels like they're putting too much into it. Like, it feels like he's throwing a lot of shit in there, which he would have put in this middle movie, and it's going to be a feel rushed the whole
time.
It's
only 2.5 hours, too, so it's not like it's a 3-hour movie. Like, it's going to be hard.
Is it longer or shorter than The Last Jedi?
The Last Jedi was the longest Star Wars movie. I don't think it was 2.5 hours, like 2 hours and 19 minutes, maybe. I don't know. I've only watched it twice. So I didn't like it.
Yeah. Oh shit.
So yeah, they're doing this big thing where it's like, it's the end of the Skywalker saga, all these fucking 9 movies and this big wrap off of the entire saga. It's like, I haven't been thinking about it in those terms. I don't think about the original trilogy or the prequels when I think about these movies. I'm just thinking about the last movie and The Force Awakens.
Well, it's its own trilogy, it's supposed to be. Mm. At the end of the Skywalker trilogy, it's like, I never thought of it as a Skywalker trilogy. Anyway, well, it was just part of the story.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And then they, fuck.
Your phone distracted you.
Yeah, my phone distracts me. I normally mute it, but I forgot. I'm drunk.
People keep telling me they know me. No one does.
All that second Death Star stuff, it looks like a cool, like, action set piece. I mean, I know it might not be, like, a well-written story, but... See, like, the shots of the water and the second Death Star and the throne room from the Jedi and stuff.
Oh, you mean the destroyed Death Star?
Yeah.
I was sitting there thinking, like, oh my god, was there the Death Star, another Death Star that I didn't see? But, yeah, no.
The one from Jedi.
The wreckage, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And there was, like, a shot of an old school, like, original trilogy Star Destroyer coming out of the ice and shit.
Yeah, okay, so one thing I didn't pick up on until I watched the other teaser, again, is the fact that, remember I showed that massive shot of all the Star Destroyers?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They weren't First Order Star Destroyers. They were...
Yeah, yeah, they were like original Star series.
So, well, a guy who I watches on YouTube who analyzes this sort of
What's
shit.
What's his name?
The Stupendous Wave. He's pretty cool. Yeah, he pointed out, well, not to me, obviously, but to the people watching his videos, that there were Imperial Star Destroyers. And then he was like, the scene where the TIE fighters fly down,
I was like,
I didn't think about it at the point. It's like, he's trying to examine if they were Imperial or First Order TIE fighters. There is a chance they won't be working together.
Well, people have brought up time travel.
No, we don't need time travel.
Time travel.
And Hayden Christensen is rumoured to be in it. Which I never liked Hayden Christensen. He or could be a that force depiction ghost, though. Of Anakin. But why do we need it?
We don't.
We don't even need this
fan
movie.
Fan service, really. Though.
Really? But
Is there any fans?
No, there are fans for the prequels. But there's like also a lot of hate. It's complicated, right? Mm-hmm. Here's our episode one review. It takes us an hour to describe how we feel about episode one. It's complicated.
But it's a good video, but check it out.
Hmm.
At least I think so.
Did you watch El Camino? A Breaking Bad story?
I did. I was wondering if we were going to review that or not.
We can talk about it here briefly in this Star Wars trailer review. What did you think?
I liked it, I think.
I enjoyed it, right? But this is how I went into it. So I hadn't watched Breaking Bad since it finished, which apparently was like...
It did that recap, though.
It did. And I did watch that. But that was like 7 years ago, right? I didn't realise time flew. But time flies. So it was hard for me to get back into the world. I'm like, is Jesse really...
I just rewatched the whole series.
Yeah,
so...
See, I haven't watched it for fucking 7 years. That's crazy, man. I wasn't even dad then.
Yeah, right.
I wasn't even smoking crack then. Well, I am now. So it was hard for me to get back into that world. Also, everyone's aged 7 years. Like when they cut to Mike, yeah. And they cut to
Walter. I don't think
Walter.
Mike and Walt... Okay, the scene with Walt fucked me because he was an obvious skin cap instead of him actually being bald, and I couldn't look past that. I mean, don't get me wrong, it didn't make me hate this scene. I could not notice it.
Yeah,
it was fair enough. You know, he's only a cameo, so why would he cut his hair off?
I felt like there was no need to tell the story. It wasn't an important story. It felt anticlimactic at the end.
His exact reason, like, who would have guessed that he would have just gone and done the guy like everyone else, like. He went and got relocated.
It was a generic story, which was well executed, but it wasn't a story worth telling, and I feel like it's anticlimactic after... Yeah.
He got...
But when he sung Sharing the Night Together with Dr. Hook, that was fucking amazing.
That was brilliant.
That was amazing, because we grew up on Dr. Hook.
I was generally shocked that it was Dr. Hook.
It's a pretty underground band these days. Our parents played it at family barbecue, so it's like inbred into our genetics.
My wife is not a fan. She doesn't like his voice. And I was just nudging her, being like, hey, you know that band you don't
like? Looking kind of lonely, girl, can I sit here?
Looking kind of lonely, girl. Can I sit here? Would you like someone new to talk to? Oh, yeah.
So that was a cool scene, but like most of it was flashbacks, and I feel like it didn't need to be told, and it wasn't amazing, but it was good.
And Bryan Cranston was there for the sheer fact that he needed to be in there.
But what did that scene achieve? What did you get from that scene?
That's what I'm saying, nothing.
They talked in a diner about Jesse, you should do good with your life.
Yeah.
Okay.
It wasn't necessary, but it was kind of nice to go back and see everyone again.
Yeah.
Jesse was noticeably older, though.
They all were. Mike looked like dog shit.
Yeah, but he looked like dog shit by the end of the series anyway.
That's true. Alright, so in conclusion, this trailer had stuff in it, and I'm kind of looking forward to Star Wars.
Oh, we're still going to watch a midnight screening. If I'm correct, you bought the tickets already.
Yeah, we're going to Gold Class, the midnight screening.
Midnight screening, and then...
So,
I mean, last time we did that, it worked out really well.
Can I tell them what happened?
Yeah, tell
them what happened. We got really blazed, and we sat down, and within the first, like, 10 minutes, there was your mum joke.
Yeah.
And then Luke was like, huh, yeah,
that,
with
no,
the lightsaber.
Before the lightsaber, but the mum joke, I was literally just like, what's happening? What's happening?
Well, when Luke threw the lightsaber, it was played like a comedy gag.
We legit turned to each other.
I was like, what? We were like, what the fuck?
Try not to be loud though. We're trying to be so quiet.
Yeah, yeah.
We're in cinemas.
Yeah, but really blazed and like, just like, what is going on? What is this? Isn't the movie I thought it was going to be.
No.
So we're going to do this again with this one and see what happens.
Yeah.
Please like, subscribe, and in the comments below. It's got all the facts on our opinions. I know the boy.
I'm feeling kinda lonely too, if you don't mind. Can I sit down here beside you? Oh yeah, alright.